Imagine being able to harness the power of light to push tiny objects, creating a whole new class of devices that help navigate deep underground, improve magnetic resonance imaging, and process microwave signals at the level of single particles of light. The Hybrid Optomechanical Technologies, HOT, Future Emerging Technologies H2020 project has brought together with 17 partners from academia and industry to advance these technologies. Let's take a look at what HOT has achieved.
Our consortium has implemented combined opto and electromechanical systems that transfer signals from the electronic domain to the optical domain and vice versa via a mechanical interface. We have optimized these devices for high signal quality. That means low added noise and high transfer efficiency.
One of the things that we worked on was the idea of going from one moving element to many moving elements. Now, this allows us to access entirely new domains of physics, like the strong coupling regime, in which we can see genuinely quantum effects rising up to the surface. Apart from this, the idea of having more than one moving element allows us to look at synchronization physics and chimera states, and these are entirely new kinds of motion on the microscale, through which we can devise new ways of generating and transporting and processing information using sound.
In HOT, we have confined both light and mechanical motion to the smallest possible scales in on-chip devices. This creates very strong interactions between photons and phonons, light and motion. This is useful for applications ranging from molecular sensing to integrated photonics.
First achievement was for me to understand the language of the physics behind the researcher, and at the same time to teach them the language of the semiconductor industry. The main target and the actual achievement we had in the project was the assembly in industrial package of the R&D prototypes.
We did not only study the packaging of advanced optomechanical devices, but also their fabrication in standard manufacturing environments as those used in the CMOS industry, and as you see also here in the background.
With such compact devices, which we call transducers, the power of quantum information processing could secure data sharing, in addition to creating networks of quantum devices.
The mutual show-up and exchange that have been created between academia and the industry. It's pretty intangible now, but this is an important seed that will create innovation in the next years.
To bring our science, our network, closer to everyone, we created a game, a mobile phone or tablet-based game, that teaches children about the science of light through learning, basically. We had a good relationship with artists. In fact, we had a very large-scale installation called Light Pushes Stuff, which went to a few countries outside Europe as well. And finally, we also wanted to bring the science part of the network close to industry. And we did that by writing in magazines like IEEE Spectrum. So that way, we targeted all sectors of society which can benefit from our technologies.
In supporting MoDA's management of dissemination and engagement efforts in the HOT network, we worked on bridging the gap between gender and science, most especially in optomechanics, by moderating and preparing workshops at conferences to bring this discussion to the fore.
HOT researchers have combined motion and electromagnetic fields on a single chip, making these devices very compact. With its discoveries, HOT has paved the way to future and emerging technologies and proposed several hybrid devices for better medical imaging, more precise navigation, and signal processing at the quantum level.